So one of the things that makes this project unique is that we're taking the wings off, but we're taking the wings off by unbolting them. And that's not an easy thing to do. I'll show you in a second how many bolts there are. On each wing, there's about 250 bolts that have to be undone. And the reason we're unbolting it is because we want the wing to be to maintain its original strength, because we're going to be placing it on supports underwater, and it's going to be at an angle, so there will be some forces exerted on the wings, both upward and downward, when the currents hit it and the wing's at an angle. So what we had to do is we had to send somebody inside the wing while it was still attached to the aircraft, and they essentially had to unbolt probably about 240, 250 bolts on each side of the wing, on each side of the aircraft. And these bolts have been in place for almost 40 years. They're covered with a kind of a caulking, a mastic type substance that's that they turned to steel after sitting there for 40 years. And it was not a nice job. So that's the bad part, but the worst part is to try to get these wings back on. The tolerances between the fittings and the flanges, where the bolts have to reconnect to the fuselage, there's almost no clearance at all. We're going to see that in a little while. So when a wing weighs about 16 tons, about 2 meters, 2.5 meters high, and 38 meters long, you can see it's not going to be an easy thing. We used excavators to attach chains. We attached chains to excavators to pull the wings off. A fair bit of tugging had to happen before the wings actually let loose. And so now the wings are here. This is the wing segment. Basically, it's just stored on tires now. When it was pulled off the aircraft, we had it resting on two shipping containers, and that was used to slide it out. But then it was lifted by crane onto these tires, and that's where it's going to sit until it goes onto another trailer for transportation out of here. Now, just to give you a sense of the scale of the wing, it's about 2 meters thick at the root of the wing, and it's 38 meters long, and it weighs 16 tons. That's, of course, 16 tons empty. We were talking before about the bolts that had to be undone. You see you got about 140 bolts or more along the bottom. Each one of these had to be undone. The mastic and the coating and that crazy caulking had to be removed. But you see all of these bolt points, they have to connect to a corresponding very tight fit along the wing box of the aircraft, which you see here. So you can see the challenge is going to be first to position the main spar into this box. Remember, this is a 16 ton wing, 38 meters long, 2 meters high. So the wing spar has to go fit inside that box. And then that box rather. And then all those bolts, all these flanges have to be lined up and the bolts have to be put back in. And just to give you an idea, to take it off, take the wing off the aircraft, this is the space that guys worked in to get all these bolts clean and to remove them, to ultimately remove the wing. Not a nice job. Glad it wasn't me. So those pieces of what looked like wings, they're going to attach into here, and they're going to then make this whole wing look nice and uniform and make all the bits and pieces look smooth. These surfaces are going to be locked into place so that they're not drooping like they are now. So walking along the wing here, 38 meters long, 16 tons heavy. The fuel tanks have had holes cut into them so they'll vent. We also added some points where we can lift from, and surfaces like this one, like the aileron. Now the ailerons will be locked into place, so make a nice clean surface like that.